So these are the new Arboreal Keeper enclosures, and they are specially designed for, like it says, arboreal spiderlings and small juveniles. So the box itself is about the size of a light bulb. And what we're going to do today is I'll just unpack them, and I've got these two spiderlings as well. One Carabina versicolor and one Peru purple. And we're just going to set up these brand new little things, have a quick look at them and see what they're all about. First impressions, they are well cool. Oh, they've got some good strong plastic, nice actual clip, secure clip, J clip. Cool. It's also a lot of look at what I've seen. So what I've seen as well, it's got a stopper in it, so you can water or feed without actually disturbing the spider itself. There's top ventilation there. Slits, and there's no way your any size spiderling, tarantula spiderling, is going to be able to get out of that. And also some cross ventilation as well. Probably get my grubby fingers all over, fingerprints all over it now. But so cool. Let's set these up. Now you can use cork bark for this, and I do have some cork bark here. But it's an absolutely lovely tube. I don't want to smash it down just to pop into these. So I've got bark is exactly like a cork bark. I think what we'll do, we'll just fill the substrate just to, there's an actual line there on both. I like to keep everything the same, standardized, so that, you know, when they're all on the shelf, they all kind of look uniform. Standard coir substrate. It's got a little bit of like a coconut hair on it. Let's sort the other one out as well. And then look, as a last nice little touch, I'm just going to place a little tiny bit of moss in there. And same with the other. Because, you know, even though you've got tiny little sling pots and tiny spiderlings, you can still look, make it look kind of quite nice. Look at that. I really like these. They are pretty much a game changer, aren't they? For especially for things like Avix, even little Porkies, Postlotheria. I think that these are well smart. What say you? Right then, so the last thing there is just pop these spiders in. So let's do the versicolor first. Let's take this off. It's super easy just to open up as well, look at that. Get my little tweezers. Little baby versicolor, look at that. Can it come out? Nope, gonna walk up the tongs instead, didn't you? There we go. Just dropped in onto the moss. Closed. Nice. So where's the Versi now in there? And same as put the Peru Purple in. And do exactly the same again. There we go, look, this one's a tiny little bit bigger. Sorry, concentrating. There we are, and in. And how are you doing? You can see now, they are damn cool, aren't they? I gotta be honest, I really like those. Really like them. And let's see what it says on the box. Purpose-built terrarium for raising arboreal spiderlings and mantis nymphs. Good call. Yeah, I didn't straight away think about mantis nymphs, but they're brilliant as well. The two-piece detachable design is ventilated at the top with additional adjustable side ventilation to create a cross flow of air exchange. The pluggable feeding hatch in the top allows food items to be introduced without disturbing web nests made by Avicularia species and jumping spiders. Jumping spiders would be absolutely pucker in that, wouldn't they? I mean, I struggle to find decent tall pots for jumping spiders, but these are cool. I think, like I said, that these are a game changer. Even room for a tiny little water bowl in there as well. Plenty of ventilation. Now you can see you can see the ventilation on top now. It's basically the whole top is nearly all ventilation. And then I get you, what you do, right? Is to adjust the side ventilation. You just turn it. So if you want it full on, you just lock it in. And you can do it half. That's really good. I'm a fan of that. So yeah. Big fan of these. Massive fan of them, in fact.